So at the Growth Lab, we are very interested in understanding why some countries are richer than others, why some cities grow faster than others. What is it that makes people productive? That's the essential question that we're trying to ask. Now, one of the things that we started looking at was how people actually organize themselves to become productive. Because one of the most salient features of today's production is that we work in teams. We have very large teams working together to build very complex products. So why do we do that? Well, one way to think of it is that there's nowadays so much knowledge in the world that if you would have to study everything and cram all of that knowledge in your head, it would take more than a lifetime to do so. So what did we do? We actually started dividing this knowledge across more and more people. We created specialists. So by dividing knowledge across people, we solved the problem that humans have only a limited cognitive capacity, but that there's a whole lot of knowledge that we want to use. At the same time, we created a problem, because no single person can nowadays create any of the complex products that we routinely want to create. So that's why we started looking at teams. And what we were particularly interested in is how does the specialization of one person affect the specialization of another person, or better, how do the skills of one person affect the value of the skills of other persons? And to do so, we relied on a very large data set from Sweden, which had the administrative records for the entire population of Sweden, some 9 million people, for 10 years. In those data, we see not just what people do at work, so we know their occupation, we know their wage, we also know where they work, so who is their employer, but we also know exactly what they studied. So we know the exact skills that people acquired throughout their educational life. Now, what that allows us to do is to see how the educational specialization of one person affects the wages of other people in the establishment. So the main idea is that if I become very specialized, then there are a lot of skills that I don't have myself, and I will have to rely on my coworkers to provide those skills. So what we wanted to know is which educations are complementary to one another and which educations can substitute for one another. And to do so, we started looking at who works together. And the idea behind that is simple. Firms actually know which educations would complement each other, because what they need to do is they need to hire a team of workers who have all the skills they require to produce their output. So by looking at who firms combine into teams, we get an idea of which educational backgrounds would be complementary to one another. And by looking at which educations allow you to do the same jobs, we could get a good idea of which types of educations would allow workers to substitute for one another. So the idea behind the latter is that if two people can carry out the same tasks, so if two people can go into the same occupations, then their skills are probably substitutable for one another. It turned out that those two quantities are extremely important when it comes to careers and wages of individuals. Having a lot of complementary coworkers increases your wage. Having a lot of substitutable coworkers, so workers who can substitute you at work, tends to decrease your wage. It is also the case that having a lot of complementary coworkers means that you are more likely to stay longer with that same firm, and having a lot of substitutes among your coworkers means that you're more likely to leave earlier. So for instance, the urban wage premium. If you work in a large city, you earn a higher wage. People have estimated that for each doubling of the city size, wages go up by about 5%. Now, what the research shows is that this wage premium is only earned by workers who actually find complementary coworkers in a city. So workers who find a lot of complementary coworkers in the city, who use the city to find the right team to work in, they actually earn an urban wage premium of 9%. So if the city size doubles, wages go up by 9% for this category of workers. Workers who do not find any complementary coworkers in a city, they also hardly get any benefits from working in a large city. For them, wages go up by only 1% for each time the city size doubles. So this benefit of having complementary coworkers, it doesn't just determine the benefits of working in a large city or working in a large establishment. It actually also determines the value of your own skills. And I think this is the single most important point of the paper. What we found is that in Sweden, on average, people with a college degree earn about 60% more than people who only have a primary school degree. However, this very much depends on how many complementary coworkers these people have. So college-educated workers with many complementary coworkers around them, they earn a premium of 90% over primary school educated workers, whereas people who have a college degree but hardly any complementary coworkers, their wages are similar to workers who only have a secondary degree. So they get hardly any return to their education. So this suggests, overall, this suggests that it's not just important what kind of skills you acquire in your life, but also who you find to combine those skills with. So who do you find to work with to make the most use of those skills?